Okay, I'm here with Scott Gonneau, CTO of Hortonworks. Thanks for coming to Solex Empower today, Scott. That was a great keynote presentation. The crowd was riled, so thanks for that. Scott, let me fire a few questions at you. What are your thoughts on the data-driven enterprise? How can you monetize your data today? How can you better monetize your data with Hadoop?
Well, we're seeing a lot of customers really take advantage of new data sources and combining new data sources with their existing data sources for monetization. As we talked about earlier today, one of the key things to really get going in this new process is to understand how to get to that end game as quickly as possible. And that is, you got to start by landing the data. This is not data and analytics of the 1990s anymore. Right? In those days, you had structured transactional data that you owned internally, you understood the schema, so it was very well controlled. And so you would start with business requirements, and then you do data sourcing, and you build an application and deliver it. In today's world, number one, sensors, mobile devices, all this stuff is changing in real time all the time. And it's generally being created perhaps outside of your firewall and outside of your control. So it's really important to get started by landing the data and giving your data scientists full access to that data so that they can then actually find the requirements that will then lead you to that monetization opportunity.
Okay, thanks. If I load all my data in one place, let's say a data lake, and clearly that's what I want to do, because if I have it in one place, then I can monetize it. What are the data governance concerns? And what are the data governance solutions that we have?
Data governance is a really big deal. And actually, I have a really good friend who's a CTO of another company who, instead of saying data lake, says data reservoir, right? Because a lake just kind of happens. A reservoir is purpose-built, right? And when you think about the value of the asset that's contained in there, it really needs to be purpose-built with some sort of a plan. And then, obviously, it needs to be managed, just like a reservoir really needs to be managed. So, earlier I said about getting to that monetization. It's about getting as much data as possible there and giving your data scientists unrestricted access to that data. That doesn't imply that there's no governance. It implies that there's a new need for governance out there. In the Hadoop 2.0 world that we live in now, right? We're able to do batch and interactive. We're able to do good firewalls around the clusters. We're able to do encryption. We're able to do very fine-grained security. And we're able to integrate the security with the governance rules or metadata tagging so that there's now full control of who accesses what, how they access it, and there's logging capability as well for a rearview mirror look at what went on. So it's highly secure. And it's really a matter of defining the governance requirements kind of at a business strategy level and then go implement that inside of the native tools that come with the cluster.
Oh, thanks. That's excellent. Scott, looking forward now, what big data applications are going to play the key roles in the enterprise? And what are you seeing that companies are doing where they're deploying this technology and it's becoming their key application?
I think... First off, I don't know the answer like forever, but the ones that we're seeing right now tend to be taking advantage of a couple of things. One is they take advantage of extremely large amounts of data for discrete analytics and predictive models, kind of data at rest, but also take advantage of applying those models to data that is in motion, maybe streaming from a mobile device while a customer is in the store or in the branch. And being able to combine all of that into kind of a single interaction with a customer is kind of where it's at. And so extending into that, the near-term stuff that I'm seeing with a lot of customers across multiple industries is that 360-degree real-time view of the customer, where they're able to combine the understanding of the customer's behavior for the last 5 years, 10 years of interaction, understand third-party data that they may buy about demographics and location and other things that can help them better understand the customer, whether it be integrating social networking data and contextual information to get sentiment of the customer, along with what they just purchased in real time on their mobile device, and really create a relevant conversation. That's one of those near-term apps that we're seeing a lot of very competitive companies go and excel today.
Scott Gonneau, CTO of Hortonworks, thank you very much.
Thank you.